Well, installing graphics mod in San Andreas just increase your visual experience, not the gameplay. So hey guys, this is Mods here, welcome back to the new video. So I'm back with another video of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas mods. Well, in today's video, I'm going to share with you active dashboard, improved vehicle feature, plus first person. Well, with all of this mod combined, you will get the best gameplay experience. Now, some of you are thinking how it will increase our gameplay experience. Let me show to you. And talking about our first person mod, so this mod allows you to play the game in a first person perspective. Well, talking about our active dashboard, so this mod turns on your indicator lights, headlights, steering wheel, wipers, and many more features you cannot imagine. So do you want to know how to install and how to use this mod into your game? Please make sure to watch this video till end. So without wasting any more time, let's get started to the video, guys. Alright guys, so as you can see, we are now a desktop screen, and first thing you will need these two files. Make sure to check description for more information. As always, first one is our optional 2.0 folder, and it's very important to install our second mod, that is our main mod, right? So all you need to do is make sure to extract your optional 2.0 folder into a game directory. And please only install the mods which are shown in this video. Do not install rest of them or you will have some problem. So once your optional 2.0 folder has been extracted, then simply just open your game directory. Now just hold on a second. As you can see, my game directory has been successfully opened. Now open your optional 2.0 folder and then open your Sleeve Accelerator Plus mod loader, and then simply just drag and drop these selected files into your game directory, right? Now hit on replace if it has. Now go back and then just open your graphics fix, right? Now from here, just simply drag and drop all of these files into your game directory, except this two Warbees file, right? Now go back, and then if you want to spawn a car or if you want to use a simple trailer, then use this RZL trainer. Now in order to install it, all you need to do is just drag and drop RZL files into your Sleeo folder. Now when you are in game, press F2 and you will gain access to this RZL trainer. So we have pretty much done with our optional 2.0 folder. Now you can close both of this window, but do not close the game window, okay? Because we have to again install our main mod, okay? So all you need to do is extract your main mod, right? Now once your main mod has been extracted, okay, so once your game directory has been opened, then simply open your active dashboard pack and then open your active dashboard folder from here, and then simply just drag and drop all of these files into your game directory, and then hit on replace if it has. Okay, now go back and then open your first person. Now without this mod, you cannot access the vehicle interiors, right? Now we have successfully done with our first person mod. Now go back and then open your improved vehicle features. Now simply just drag and drop all of these files into your game directory. Now all you need to do is just run env.exe and see the magic if it works or not. So my friend, as you can see, we are in our game, and to show our active dashboard and other features, all you need to do is just press V several times and then you will gain access to the first person menu, right? Now let's spawn a car. Now you can spawn the car in two ways, right? First of all, you can press Ctrl plus C, you can go to the vehicle spawn and then go to the sports car, and then you can spawn any of this vehicle. I will strictly recommend you to use Jericho's Mega Vehicle Pack if you don't want any trouble, right? Now just enter in our car and let's see our active dashboard is working or not. So my friends, as you can see, our active dashboard is successfully working. Our steering wheel is also successfully working, right? Now, as you can see, our speedometer is also working successfully, right? Now, you will ask, what about the indicator lights and other stuffs? Now let me show you. If you press K, then as you can see, the wipers are completely working, right? Now if you press J from your keyboard, and then as you can see, the headlights and tail lights. Now if you press X, then this indicator lights, right? I guess it's if you press X, then all indicator lights will blink, and if you press C, then I guess only right side will work, and if you press Z, then left side will work. And if you press Shift, then all indicators will be stopped. Right? Now let me show you one more feature. Right? Now if you drive this car so fast, then as you can see guys, the auto spoiler, right? It's too amazing, isn't it? Now this auto spoiler not only happens with the McLaren 615 LT, we have one more car to show you. Now just hold on a second, let me spawn that car for you. Okay, so as you can see, here's a Lamborghini. I guess it's Murcielago, right? Yeah, this is Lamborghini Murcielago. So when I drive this car so fast, as you can see, its spoiler are completely working. So yeah guys, that's pretty much for today. Thank you so much for watching till then. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, then please make sure to leave a like on this video, share this video to as much as you can. And yeah, as always, I'll see you into the next one. Till then, goodbye.